Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you three alternatives to using macOS dictation. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So macOS Catalina has two different built-in methods for doing dictation. But if neither of those seem to work well for you, here are three alternatives for dictating text. So you have two ways to do this just using macOS. The first is in System Preferences, go to Keyboard, go to Dictation, Enable Dictation, and then you can press the FN key twice and dictate some text. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. The other method is to go into Accessibility and then use Voice Control. And once you enable that, that includes powerful dictation tools far beyond the basic stuff. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog, period. Now those two options should work in just about any app. But sometimes it doesn't work in specific situations. And sometimes, depending upon probably your voice, your accent, your speed of talking, and all sorts of other things, it doesn't seem to work very well for dictating large documents. So you have some other things that you can try. First, if you're a Microsoft Word user and you have the current version of Word, and the current version is version 16, and of course you have your subscription set up and you're signed in, then in your home ribbon here, you should see a dictate button. Now this is different than macOS's built-in dictation. In fact, you can use that as well. You can even see it here if you go to Edit, there's Start Dictation. So you can use the regular dictation tools in Word. But if you click this Dictate button, it will use Microsoft Word's built-in dictation. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. And you just click it again to turn it off. Now option two is to use Google Docs. So Google Docs is free. You get to it by just signing into your Google account, which is your Gmail account for most people. You go to docs.google.com, you start a new word processing document, and right in here you've got under Tools, Voice Typing. Now this is important because macOS's built-in dictation won't work here. It just simply doesn't recognize this as a text entry area because this is all specialized web app code here. Now one really important thing, you have to use the Chrome web browser for this. The voice dictation function uses an extension that I guess doesn't meet Safari's security requirements. So it only works in Chrome. So I know I'm going to get some comments about this, why isn't it working, people not seeing this tool in Google Docs. So keep in mind you have to be using the latest version of Chrome for this to work. So click on Tools and then Voice Typing, or you can see it's Command Shift S. You see this button right here, click it and go. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. So if you don't like either of those two options, here's another one. Go to dictation.io and there's a tool to allow you to dictate to a simple text document here. You can actually type in it as normal, but you can also use the dictation function. Now this also needs to run in the Google Chrome browser just like with Google Docs because it's using probably the same technology that Google Docs is. So here we'll start and try it out. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. So the idea here is that when you're done you can copy and paste what you've got or you can hook it up with some other different types of services as well. So it might be good for dictating a block of text if nothing else is working well for you and then copying and pasting into an email or page document or whatever.
I think when choosing one of these methods you basically have to try them all out and see which works better for you. I would of course recommend using the macOS default stuff first, particularly using voice control if you plan on doing a lot of dictation. But if you plan on just dictating single sentences, little text messages, a bit here, a bit there, then use the keyboard dictation function. The Microsoft Word option only really works if you already have a Microsoft Word subscription. But if you are a Word user using that for all of your word processing, then that's probably your best option. After that, I would go with Google Docs unless you really don't want to use Google services. And then maybe try that dictation.io site, which also could be really useful if you're using a friend's computer or another computer. You don't want to set any of those other things up and you just need to do some quick writing using dictation.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.